All right. You want to play the Anchor Challenge? Go to KTLA.com/Anchor Challenge. Give us a little information. We may pick up the phone and call you one morning, and you could play.
You know, I never used to watch that show. Now I'm addicted to it.
Have you seen that? Not to take nothing away from it. And by the way, the incredibly handsome, talented Chris Cagle. Have you seen the 2.5 Men cookie jar?
No.
No.
It's better than the beach towel.
Really?
So if they offer you the beach towel, demand the cookie jar. Because it's, of course. But it's, yeah, thank you. It's a Hawaiian shirt. It's the shirts that he always
wears. Why did you wear your cowboy hat today?
I should have, but I didn't want to outdo Chris Cagle.
You have a cowboy hat?
I do.
How can you outdo someone who wears it every day?
Right.
That's true. Good point, Chris.
See, I'm a poser, and you're the real deal. He's at the top of the charts, and no question, the single is What Kind of Gone. Chris Cagle is here. Thanks for being here.
It's my pleasure.
And you know, here's the thing that you write about, which is so interesting, that you listen to all these demo records. You said 4,000 songs before you picked the ones you put on your CD?
We have actually on a spreadsheet, because I knew people wouldn't believe this, but we listened to over 4,000 records. And, you know, being a songwriter, one of the things that was very important to me is a lot of people in Nashville, you'll see them go play, and you'll hear first verse, chorus, and they'll pass, and they'll pitch it in the trash. There's a lot of time and effort that goes into a song as a writer, and a lot of effort goes into the presentation. And I've never had any of the names and the quality of writers that are on this record pitch me songs like this before.
What is it that you hear, though, that maybe we don't?
Well, sometimes you have to hear through a lot, especially people who think they can, like, sing. I mean, you know what I mean?
You're sort of wading through the bad quality of the demo to get the
absolutely
gem of the song.
And some of them, there's some writers who just take one of those little old micro recorders and push play, and I was born, you know, and it's, I mean, but the bottom line is a hit song is a hit song, and if it happens, and if you can hear it through that, when you add the bells and whistles and slick it up and cut its hair, it's going to be
cut its hair,
a beautiful,
I like that.
A beautiful entity itself. So, but I'm really proud of this album. Scott Hendricks getting involved, I think, lended a tremendous amount of credibility to me as an artist, and I think as a result, a lot of Nashville's elite writers. This is the first album I've ever recorded that I didn't have anything on there as a writer. So.
Wow.
Now, though, and I don't want to, you know,
while we're chatting, I don't even know what to say. We have some of Chris's music that we're going to sneak in as we're going on. Go ahead.
Okay. I don't want to bog you down, and all of a sudden, but if you're listening to 4,000 songs, in other words, all comers, or you're willing to listen to anybody, including mine or whatever.
Yes, sir. Actually, when I receive a CD for consideration, I don't have a publisher's name on it. I do not have the writer's name on it, because they're influential. You know, a Craig Wiseman or a David Berg or a Brett James or a Neil Thrasher, you see that name and all of a sudden you think, I gotta listen to this pile first. Mm. Because they've written so many hits for other people. When in fact, I wanted each song to just stand on its merit, no quit. I mean, the guy on the street corner could have got, you know.
What is it that makes a hit? I was listening to a song the other day on the radio and I thought, that's a hit, and I'm sure they knew that from the get-go, but how do you know? What's the anatomy of a hit?
What made it a hit for you? See what I'm saying? That for me, I have to absolutely be in a place where I can actually stop and listen. I can't do it, you know, driving in a truck full of people. And I have to make sure I remember and hold on to what that song did to me the moment I heard it.
Gotcha.
Because that's what it's going to do to other people, hopefully.
We got two videos here, Miss Me Baby or the Walmart parking lot. Which one should we pick?
My favorite's Miss Me Baby.
Oh, well, then you know what? He asked for it. It's like, you asked for it, we play it. It's Chris Cagle's Miss You Baby. Look.
Count when he's holding you. Know that it's killing me. Let my memory be the reason, girl, that you can't sleep. And every time you feel his touch.
All right, Chris styled apparently by his mom, who, so now, Kenny Chesney, a lot of stars are like this. Will you ever take that hat off?
I don't mind taking it off. I mean, will I ever take it off for what?
Like in pop, like there's some country stars you never see without their hat.
Oh, you know what? That's just because they're insecure. I mean, look, I'm losing my hair a little bit. Doesn't bother me. This is the way God made me. If I'm not good enough, then, you know
what
I mean?
How many hats do you have?
7.
That's
well,
it.
I've got two of these, two of a different. It's so funny because my dad's like, now what's this one for? Yeah.
Let me tell you a couple things about Chris. K-Frog, which is a bit like, have you ever listened to K-Frog in the Inland Empire? Like,
sure.
Best station ever, 95.1, celebrating their 18th birthday, sending their viewers to an invitation-only concert with Chris.
Nice.
That's going to be at Casino Morongo on Thursday, and that's fantastic. And then the new CD is called Chris Cagle, My Life's Been a Country Song. What a pleasure. When are you coming back with the band to actually perform on our little stage?
Whenever you ask, and we will come back anytime.
Tomorrow.
Mr. Cagle, may I add, best-smelling guest ever.
Oh, thank you.
Seriously, wow. I've just been sitting here enjoying.
I'll tell you the story off the air. It's
really funny.
Yeah, I was embarrassed and kind of... Things in L.A. are a little more expensive than they are in the country.
Yes,
and I put this bottle of cologne up on the counter here, and the girl's like, that'll be $425.
Oh, no.
And I was like...
For Aqua Velva?
Yeah, I was like, okay. You know, so I was stuck, but I would never... But I didn't want to just, like, I'm in line. I'm,
it was
well, it's working
every
for you. Already
so,
it's
working.
I'm going back to see you today, and I'm going to get me some
five more bottles.
We're in debt to Chris Cagle for coming here, and Chris Cagle now in debt for being here. Thank you so much.
It paid off. Good to see you, Chris.
Thank you, man.
Coming up, explorers still exist. Gale is gearing up to send one off on his next adventure.
She's